I'm here on the Northern Adelaide Plains. We're out in an almond farm where the Emlid Reach RS units have been adopted and trialled to improve the positioning quality of the tractors that are conducting spray operations here on the almond orchard. Today we're going to take a look at how Andrew has integrated the Emlid receivers with legacy Topcon, Trimble and New Holland GPS hardware.
It came as second-hand gear from the broadacre sector. So initially it was just a tree sprayer that we set up, and I've got a 18-metre boom spray, which I've also used the GPS controlling that. Started off with the Topcon Key Technologies X15 as they were known in the day, and then we were able to obtain a X20, and since then I've bought a second X20. So if you look after it, while the hardware keeps working, it's doing a great job. We were using a Trimble 132 receiver.
You've been using the Maritime Safety Authority's differential beacon to improve the positioning on your Trimble unit. I understand that's now been deactivated by the government. That created some challenges for you.
Yes, certainly did. Well, we certainly didn't get the accuracy, which meant our lines were getting moved a lot further out, to the point where a row space is 7 metres and it's taking you into the next row and then back again, which makes it difficult when you want to go back and spray and it thinks you've already sprayed there and it turns the sprayer off. I think this is where I came into conversation with Alistair. I could put an Omnistar subscription on the Trimble 132, but it was something I didn't really want to have to fork out money for. I don't necessarily need the accuracy that Broadacre has, but I want something where I can just can get my nice straight lines within the row.
And at $3,800 for a brand new unit, something that offers you, you know, precision down to a couple of centimetres, I guess that meant that the Emlid unit was a fairly natural choice for you to at least explore.
Yeah, definitely. What I liked about it, obviously with trees, we want to be able to protect the receiver or the antenna. This unit's very similar in size to the Trimble 132 antenna. You know, we just put it under a PVC end cap we can buy from the local irrigation supplier.
Like for like, it fitted beautifully inside that little slot.
Went in there perfectly.
So because it's plastic, the microwaves from a satellite can actually pass through this and still maintain the GPS signal for the antennas or GNSS receivers that are mounted on the back of the tractor. So you don't necessarily need the centimetre accuracy that the Reach units offer you, but because of the price point of them, it's a pretty natural thing just to try them out.
Definitely. I think, and they're so versatile. You know, you've got with a data card in there, you can access it through the telephone network, or with a second receiver on the shed, have a base unit.
And that's really important, not just to deliver a correction into this unit to provide the, you know, survey grade positioning. Well, I was reading on one of the forums the other day about someone that was actually using their Reach RS2 connected to their mobile device to get the signal from the RS2 and to stream Netflix onto their mobile device. One thing that we've been learning through our trials here is that these almond orchards are a bit like a RF sink. They just really soak up radio signal, whether that's mobile signal or the radio correction that's being broadcast from a base to a rover. So one of the things that we've recently done is loan some extended range antennas. And then today we've brought along one of the brand new Reach RS2 Plus, one of the first in the country. And the Reach RS2 Plus has an LTE modem in it, which allows it to work on 4G networks. We want to really see if this is going to improve the opportunities for the tractor operator to be able to receive a correction from a continuously operating reference station service like AusCorps or SmartNet. So in here we've got the antenna on each side. We've got our comms port underneath to attach the serial cable. So we've got a waterproof data connection down to the spray control unit. But the beauty of this over the Trimble unit is that all of the processing is done on board here, and this is already exporting out a corrected positioning stream, and the Reachview software allows you to configure that positioning stream so that it's able to be consumed by older legacy control units that are expecting older formats in terms of the positioning data. So the two things that Andrew's had to do is to figure out the correct positioning string to use, and that's all configurable again within the Reachview unit, within the Reachview software using your phone. And once he's got the correct data coming out, he's also had to determine the correct cable pinout to match the cables coming from the spray control unit, with the cables coming from the Emlid. So you've actually got a little junction box that allows you to sort of marry those cables up in the correct order?
Yeah, I went down to J-Car and bought a little box and a terminal strip. Going to open up the little box I built to connect the reach through to my Topcon X20. So this is the reach cable that was supplied, serial cable, which I just bought and cut the end off, and a two-wire power cable. And then we've configured this in the setting so that when the screen here fires up, it powers this up, and then that tells the reach to power up, and it also charges it while it's running, keeps the batteries and the reach charged up. These two are the power wires, and these three are the serial wires going into the unit, which is sending the RS232, TX and RX power wire going out. Probably an hour's work mucking around. I think what I ended up putting a dob of solder on each one. The other thing is with using a terminal block, if you get them wrong, you can experiment until you find the right ones.
Yeah, so anyone trying this at home, there are pinout diagrams available for the range of Emlid cables so that you know exactly which pins to use.
The other thing, in an orchard situation, I think where it could be beneficial is I can take this unit off the tractor, put it on a pole, and actually use it for surveying. You know, we locate a pipe that's damaged. I can go out there, mark that pipe, 2 centimetre accuracy. I'll be able to go back there and find that again.
So today we've visited Sharpe Almonds and Andrew's explained how they're using Emlid GPS hardware to ensure that their legacy spray control units remain relevant and able to take advantage of the best possible positioning to ensure accurate application of sprays throughout their orchard. Andrew, thank you so much for your time hosting us here on your farm today. We hope that you too have enjoyed the visit here today. If you've liked the video, please feel free to hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and leave a comment below if you'd like to know more. See you next time.